Another air method. It casts blur on itself. It's coming.
Something up? Gotcha.
Good music.
Who says what?
Time to move. Good to go.
There's another one. Smoke.
You point. I pump.
Next.
Feed the earth. I don't see any earth around here, Jahira.
Next time. Yep. Just like old times. Well, except for the torture and all.
Yeah, we could do without the torture. Thought that was another flapping huge creature. First thing I think is like wyvern or something.
This place is just too darn creepy. I really want out of here.
Alright. Huh, it's a scroll of conjure air elemental. The air flowing rapidly. Wow. Well, I don't suppose we can walk along this thing. Wouldn't try it. I don't think that's a scroll I have, yeah. Upon casting a conjure air elemental spell, the caster opens a special gate to the elemental plane of air, and an air elemental is summoned in the vicinity of the caster. There's a 60% chance that a 12 hit dice elemental appears. Oh, wow, level 6. I just saw it was level 6. That's cool. 60% chance that a 12 hit dice elemental appears, 35% chance that a 16 hit dice elemental appears, and a 5% chance that a 24 hit dice elemental appears. That would be awesome. The elemental will do the bidding of the caster until it is slain or the duration of the spell runs out. All of the commands given to the elemental are done telepathically, so there is no time lost due to miscommunication and no need to know the language of the summoned creature. However, every time this spell is cast, there's a 15% chance that the elemental will escape the instructions of the caster, go berserk, and attack the wizard who dared summoning it. That would not be good. If it can't reach the summoner, it will fight its way toward her. This berserking elemental will also remain until slain or the spell's duration expires. The elemental is locked into a psychic contest with the caster for 3 rounds after being summoned. At the end of this time, if the caster has won, she has control of the elemental. However, she has lost, the elemental goes berserk and tries to kill her. This does not prevent the use of other charm-type spells after the contest was lost. If the charm spells are used before the contest is over, they will have no effect on the outcome. Alright, well, I'm gonna learn that. I'm done with that. Okay, good.
I awake your music.
Swords, not words! Mince and Boo stand back for justice!
Alright, so we got stuff up there.
What? Name.
Okay. We're hidden.
Yes? Fine.
Ready and willing. Right you are. Something up? Alright, alright.
What is such menial tasks?
Time to move?
Leaving shadows already, are we? Did she use fireball already? I guess so. I kept meaning to have her not... have a lightning bolt. Yeah, she used fireball. I'm gonna load another fireball, I believe. Let's see. Haste. Dire Charm. Clairvoyance. Flame Arrow. Haste, yeah. Launch a summoning. Watch, it's not going to help us at this point. Well, maybe she'll do a stinking cloud.
Yeah.
Actually. Mirror image.
What?
Same. Did I become visible?
Yes.
I did? Alright, never mind. So much for that. I'm gonna throw a fireball in here. And
what do you want?
A stinking cloud. Hopefully help damage the ones that are fire-based. But so the fire mephit was immune to the fireball. We killed the mist mephit and we killed something else.
What is it? A simple matter.
Every hamster see battle bo. Run, bo, run!
They're just staying where they are for now. Fun. I'm not having them move through the stinking cloud, we'll just let it do its job. Surprised we could save with monsters about.
Armored, shall make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
These two are uninjured. We killed at least two.
What?
Name it.
Feel the back.
Interesting. Huh. This looks like kind of some kind of huge pirate ship.
Yes.
Oh, I forgot to. Yeah, no, that's all. Oh, He's stunned.
I am ready.
Alright, we gotta finish this thing off. He's back.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Pretty loud around here. Nature would do anything over here. There's no ground.
What? Ready and willing? No problem at all.
There might be traps, though. There's another way up over there. What are we, harnessing wind powers here? Does he use the wind to power his dungeon?
Sword where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Something up? You can count on me.
Well, there might be more methods, so. Oh, that's interesting. It's quiet over here. What does this do? Emuin, what did you do?
Time to move? This way, then?
I'd say so. Malaaq says, I am bound. What do you... Who are you... Ah, I see. The master is gone, and you've managed to get yourselves in trouble. Well, that was a flask there? Who are you that you've been bound in this flask? Enslaved would be a more accurate word. I was captured in my home, on this plane of air, by some wizard. He bound me to this flask that I might guard his things, and something of yours. You have something that belongs to me? I do. A thing of power that still carries a hint of your essence. There is something odd about the signature that you leave on this item. No matter. Can you give it to me? If I had the power to give you your weapon, I would, but the force that binds me is strong. As long as I am trapped within this flask, I am within the mage's power. If you can secure the means of my release, I will give you a weapon. Oh good, you mean you're not going to attack us? I figured it would end with it attacking us. That sounds like a fair trade. How do I secure the means of your release? Maybe we already have it. The flask that I am bound in is a creation of magic. It is unbreakable as long as it remains apart from its twin, the real flask. The real flask. You must find the original flask and bring it back to me. Once it is within my grasp, I can break the enchantment and be freed. Where can I find this flask? He will keep the flask close to himself. The master would not risk it falling into other hands. Perhaps he keeps it in his chambers, or with his dryad concubines. Perhaps the golems have it. Alright. Well, I don't think we found his chambers yet. We found her chambers. Maybe we could go ask the dryads about it now that he's told us this. Otherwise we could find... Well, we killed the clay golems. I don't think they would have it. But if we find the sewage golem, or the jailer golem. I cannot pinpoint its location from under the plane. You shall have to search for it. Return to me when you have found it, and we shall exchange my freedom for your weapon. To retrieve what is in possession of the Djinni Malaaq, I must first secure his release by obtaining the twin to the flask he is bound to. He informed me that the flask is kept close to his master, either in his chambers or in the possession of some dryads or golems. Can we talk to him further? Please find the flask that is the twin of the one in which I am bound. Do this for me, and I shall give you a weapon of power. Well. Very interesting.
Minsk, jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
So let's return to the dryads, first of all.
The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
That's a good idea. Ah, that's not the way. Well, it's now an unlocked portal. I wonder if we can trust that Djinni. Let me ask you guys something. I search for a flask in order to free a Djinni. Have you seen such a thing? Elim says, you are very noble to risk your own safety to free the Djinni. We have the flask and shall give it to you. Huh. I have retrieved the flask from the dryads. All that remains now is to go back to the Djinni. Djinni, says, at this point, says, and return it to him. That easy, huh? He's gonna attack us. Who has the flask? Oh, that must be it. The Djinni's flask. This flask is an exact replica of Malaaq's flask. Okay. We return. We should have told us that before. Pathing here is not
yes,
best.
Yes, fine.
Yep, gotcha.
Every live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Yes, I go.
Yeah, you go this way.
I am ready as I would have done.
Yeah.
Armored, stand back for justice.
I don't think I trust it, but... whatever it has, if it does have something, could be very useful to us.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
We have returned rather quickly.
What is it?
All right.
Make way, villainy! hero coming through! You point bad kicking for goodness!
Aren't you good to go?
Alright.
Swords, not words!
Well, we're gonna have a little bit of words right now.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Malaaq says, I sense that you have the flask. Let us make the exchange. At last, I am free. Here is your item, fleshling. You're an honorable person, and I feel I must warn you. Keep away from the master. We just got 15,000 experience. A sword of chaos plus 2. And, of course, we lost the genie's flask. That's fine. He will torture you for escaping and kill you for freeing his Djinni slave. Escape from his lair quickly if you value your life. Farewell. Well, that worked out. I freed the Djinni Malaaq by retrieving a flask from 3 dryads and giving it to him. In return, he returned some equipment that he was keeping in storage for the wizard Arrhenicus. Well,
a den of stinking
one thing.
Cover your nose, Boo. We will leave no crevice untouched!
Just one thing. An indicator of a few things. Just this. Sword of Chaos plus 2. Oh! Saravak's Sword of Chaos plus 2. The blade of Saravak, brother of Sapphire, used in the battle they fought in faraway Baldur's Gate. Sapphire prevailed, destroying Saravak's plans and rescuing the Sword Coast from the brink of war. The sword itself defies identification, likely forged specifically for Saravak to best focus the infernal energy he helped to control. Much of its power died with him. That's sad. Each hit drains 1 point from the target and transfers it to the wielder. This will not heal beyond the wielder's maximum. Thaco plus 2. It's a two-handed sword. And, I don't think I'm gonna use this. Because I prefer to have Minsk dual wielding. And he's not proficient in two-handed. At least I don't think he is. Unless he came that way. I didn't put any points into it. He's starting to get full. Still wondering if we're gonna...
Minsk and Boo, stand. Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Still wondering if we're gonna come across any more party members. Or anybody. For that matter. Besides things to fight. Or deal with.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Alright. So I have a teleport portal here, and we have one back here. All these doors have been open. We've messed with all these tubes. I'm gonna head back to the beginning, believe it or not.
Live by the sword! Live a good long time!
So it appears we've cleared out this entire level. So a friend need more arrows? Not really. I didn't mean to do that. So the clay golems, the ones in here, right? If we had just killed them while they were in here, I guess there would have been nothing to respond to that alarm bell. Our friend is back here, the sewage golem. All my work is completed, Master. The Guardian feeds. There is naught else for me to do. What is the Guardian? The Atyug? He is the one who feeds on the filth and remains of the prisoners. He is the creature that guards the way to your chambers. I must return to my sleep now. Your magic compels me. He guards the way to the chambers. It was in here. Okay. I guess he's referring to this chamber. But this chamber belonged to a female. Maybe the golem just thinks it's the master's chambers. Or he meant it in a loose way. You know, the chambers that belong to you, but someone else. It's for someone else. Oh, this lightning thing here. I wonder if it works on that, actually. We have a wand of lightning key. I haven't found a use for that yet. That's loud. It does buzz with electrical energy. Oh, what's this? Did I even realize this was something? Probably so distracted by the lightning methods in here. Didn't even realize we can interact with one of these. You're too far away to use that. This is a switch of some kind. Perhaps it will stop this lightning contraption from conjuring any more of these annoying little methods.
Name it.
Oh. Wand of Lightning Key.
Ready and willing.
Maybe she has to interact. The lightning machine stops once you have flicked the switch. Flicking this switch will undoubtedly result in the machine restarting and its conjuring of more beasts. It wouldn't be wise to switch it back on.
Every hamster has his day.
But I suppose if you needed some, you know, experience.
Stand back for justice!
You could turn it back on and fight more methods. Especially if you get the Jahira spell working. Protection from lightning.
If it will help.
Armored, sharpened, the bigger they are, the harder I hit.
Let's see if this guy says anything new. The jailkeep golem. Alright, so I've read this stuff before. Who is this master? Where are we and why have we been brought here? I'm not bound to stop you. Who or what is the Guardian? The Guardian will keep you from the Master's chambers. You must return to your cells as the Master's will. I guess that is the audio. Because it feeds on sewage and stuff, and that's what those things do. Only I release the master's prisoners. Alright. I must not disobey. Whatever you say, dude. place looks like some kind of factory. Okay, so there's the portal. We used the portal key to go through. But that'll be next episode. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.